At the age of 37, Andrew Lubega, a resident of Chebando, Chisalo-Salo in Kawempe North, counts himself among the lucky few who have healed from cancer. Lubega recalls that he detected the disease at the end of 2019. From there on, he developed consistent pain, feeling it on all parts of his head.
Then the toothache got serious in 2020, January there, that even if I would just pick a phone call, I would get a terrible headache. When I stop, the headache stops. When I hold on my left side.
He then visited a dentist, and this was the beginning of a nightmare trauma.
To see a dentist, and she was like, let's just remove this tooth. And that's when the pain started. No, that's when the real pain started. Like the pain intensified. Because I'd seen several ENTs, and they're all like saying the same thing. You're having a sore throat. They would give me antibiotics and what?
Lubega went to the Cancer Institute at Mulago Hospital, where they confirmed to him that indeed he had cancer.
And they did a CT scan, and he just saw something small. Like, let's do a biopsy. Yes. Discovered that there was a mass growing in the breathing throat, called the esophagus.
The news came with shock, fear, and confusion. The doctors advised him to seek treatment at Aga Khan University Hospital in Nairobi, Kenya.
Another biopsy this time. And when they did it, the tumor, which was 2 centimeters in 2020, it had grown to 6 centimeters. So the doctor then there advised me the best place I can get that treatment is Aga Khan Hospital, Nairobi.
Lubega first sought medical attention at Aga Khan University Clinic in Kampala before being transferred to Nairobi.
When the doctor suggested I should go to Aga Khan Hospital, Nairobi, I had to go to Aga Khan, Kampala. So that's when they sent the emails to the main hospital in Nairobi, the University Hospital in Nairobi, and that's when they connected me to the specific doctor I was supposed to meet. So by the time I left Uganda, I already had a doctor who was going to attend to me and stuff like that.
At the facility in Nairobi, he explains how he felt after the first treatment.
That's when the pain stopped. From the first treatment, like the first session. And the second session, even the hearing came back. Because by the time I left, I'd lost hearing. I was not breathing like well. That's when everything else started coming back, after two sessions.
Apart from the excellent customer care, Lubega explains how he was helped to heal his heart before medication.
When you go to the doctors themselves, they're so informative. Like, they will tell you what you should expect from the treatment you're going to get.
He spent 4 months on both chemotherapy and radiotherapy treatment, and now he says he has fully recovered.
When I reached there, they told me what I was supposed to take. They told me I was supposed to have 13 sessions of chemotherapy and 35 sessions of radiotherapy. And basically, actually, that's all I did. Though it was not so easy.
Kaposi's sarcoma and cancer of the cervix are the leading killer cancers in Uganda. Lubega has advised Ugandans on what to do to avoid the illness.
But when you start feeling what you don't understand with your body, first, go and do a checkup. Because what we think might be small, or what might be small, might become something too big. That's one. Secondly, if you discover that you have cancer, because that's what I'm talking about, and it's what I survived. If you discover that you have cancer, the truth is, it's not a death sentence. You can live again.
He also lauded Aga Khan University Hospital in Nairobi for the professional conduct and care the patients enjoy at the facility.
I think I noticed people getting healed is not mainly the treatment they get, but also the care they get. Because from the entrance of the hospital to the nurses, to the doctors themselves, everyone is, they mind about the patient. A wonderful place for any kind of sickness.
Aga Khan University Hospital is also planning to construct a specialized hospital in Kampala to cater for the needs of Ugandans so they do not have to foot bills traveling to Nairobi.
We will be very soon starting construction of a tertiary care hospital as well. Again, it will be a teaching hospital. It will not just be a hospital to treat patients, but it will be a teaching hospital. We will be teaching and the future doctors for Uganda, and hopefully those doctors will Once they graduate, they will stay in Uganda and provide the good quality of service.
Report by Julius Kafuluma for the news.